Hello, people, and welcome to another edition of yours truly, Josiah Willis, here today with another reaction. Let's go right ahead and get back to it. Back to some reggae music. Reggaeton! We have my guy, Bob Marley, and the Wailers, Concrete Jungle, the official audio from the album, Catch a Fire. Because I'm sure it's going to be some fire of listen. You know what I'm saying? Some fire, you know. I kind of meant fire of a listen, just like, really? Anyways, no, we're here. Going to react to this song. Came out on April 13th, 1973. So that had to be about roughly, I want to say, 40, 50 years ago. I think so. Probably even 30. No, it's 40. Okay, anyways. Shout out to Jack Newber, Chris Blackwell, and Bob Marley himself for the production of this record. We are going to react to it. Listen, there you dive in, you know what I'm saying, break it down, all that. So with that being said, you're ready and you are prepared to enjoy this reaction as you had hit play on that play button to watch this video right here. Please do me a quick favor, and that is to like, comment, subscribe, and views. Put your minds out there. The link of this song will be down in my description below. This is Bob Marley and the Wailers. Concrete Jungle, the official audio. Here we go. And yes, you guys, a lyrical breakdown will be provided once the song is over. By the way, to give some context over this record, he wrote this song after I believe he had moved from Jamaica to the United States here. Joining his mama, who had lived here. She was living in the U.S. at the time. So he moved, you know, being close with his mother. That's wonderful. From years ago, for sure. All right, here we go. Bob Marley and the Wailers. Concrete Jungle, the official audio. Let's go. Shout out to that one guy, by the way, for requesting this song. Shout out to you, that one guy. Appreciate the request, man. Just forgot. It. Like a torso, it's nice. Yeah. Man. I'm always a sucker for that. Always a sucker for a guitar solo. Especially when it's well done like this. Hey. Another solid song by Bob Marley and the Wailers, man. Really enjoy that record. Love the guitar solo in there. The instrumentation was really captivating, you know what I mean, in its own way. Bob Marley was talking, and I mean talking, as the usual with him. Of course, you know, Bob Marley likes to always, you know, show the positivity of about his music. His music has always been like one of those feel-good records that you listen to. Like, I mean, like the way he does the genre of like reggae, you know what I mean? He's a legend, as we all know, you know, and I continue to keep doing him because I'm always curious to know what I can pick up on with Bob Marley. And the biggest thing that's really stood out to me is the man's positivity. Like, it's without shadow of a doubt, like one of the greatest attributes about him and how well you can receive that from him. You know what I mean? He's like a blessing, a vessel, you know, that was in this world. So let's go right ahead and get towards the lyrical breakdown minus the intro. With that being said, verse 1. No sun will shine in my day today. The high yellow moon won't come out to play. So I'm not quite sure if the high yellow moon is a metaphor, and let me know in the comments below what I may have missed. I'm not sure the high yellow moon may be a reference to the skin color of a black person who is light skinned, or is he talking about the source of light you see in the night sky? You know what I mean? You see the appearance of the moon and all that. But it's very interesting. It's very, very interesting. And I think it may be personifying, you know, how he mentioned about the sun. Then you got the moon. And then you got just people who are known to be... I read something about this controversy where I think it was by a guy named Leonard. Says Leonard Jeffries. Yeah, Leonard Jeffries. And he talked about like how like the black people were the sun people. And the ice people were the white people, you know what I mean? It's just, I guess you could say, in reference to the nativities due to, I guess, I read this up in college, but hot and cold climates, respectively, you know what I mean? Just very interesting. But I think Bob was just saying at the end that he personified the sun, the moon, and other elements of nature as extensions of true black existence. So, let's just say that. I said, darkness has covered my light and has changed my day into night. Man, darkness has covered your light. Wow, that's deep. You talk about going through, you know, urban issues. I say urban issues when it comes to whatever area you're around, and if you're seeing things not doing well for themselves, can make you almost feel a little depressed. Sad, man. You know what I'm saying? Somebody need to pat you in the back and comfort you and let you know that's going to be all right. It's going to be all right. One love. So, yeah. Let's continue. Where is the love to be found? Won't someone tell me? Because life, sweet life, must be somewhere to be found instead of concrete jungle. Where the living is hardest, concrete jungle. Man, you've got to do your best. Yeah, I love this. You know what I'm saying? What he's saying here essentially is keep pushing, keep striving. In the midst of your fair share of issues, your hardships, your struggles, we all have them. We all human. We're all men. We're all women. We know for a fact we're going through just a whole lot of turmoil, but you got to keep pushing. You know what I'm saying? Even when you're going through that concrete jungle, I think the concrete jungle is a metaphor. Like, if you think about concrete jungle, when I think about like a setting that's hard to get around. The jungle has all these animals, but they ain't nice animals. They're actually really mean animals. And you're looking to find a way to escape, but it's hard to come out of that, you know. It almost sounds like it's a fantasy, but you gotta come out of that reality to know you're going to escape your issues. That's how I'm taking that. So here's the second verse. He says, no chains around my feet, but I'm not free. You feel like he's still a slave, or we're all slaves. I know I am bound here in captivity. Wow, the theme of chains and captivity. They take on a much, much deeper meaning when I'm saying that too, honestly. But yeah, it's crazy. Yeah, now, I've never known happiness. I've never known what sweet caress is. Still, I'll be always laughing like a clown. Want somebody or someone help me? Because sweet life has got to be. I've got to pick myself from off the ground. In this here concrete jungle, I said, what do you got for me now? Oh, concrete jungle. Why won't you let me be now? Bob Marley's talking, man. He is talking. It may seem like it's a little, like, it's not as, what's the word for it? It's not as abstract, maybe, I don't know, to detail it. But, well, actually kind of is. It's kind of abstract. I think to myself now, where I'm thinking about something, I talk to myself, obviously, about a lot of different things. And so, trying to sway. But here we go. Verse 3, I think. I said that life, sweet life, it must be somewhere to be found. Oh, instead of concrete and jungle. The illusion. Confusion. Yeah, man. Wow, man. You know, life can be challenging. It can definitely be challenging. The illusion. Painting a picture with that imagery that he's resurfacing through. This song doesn't sound too, like, I think the point I was trying to get at was, it's not surface level. It's not. It's really not that hard to break down. However, Bob Marley is one of those artists where he can be intricate at times. He can be very intricate. And so with me trying to figure this record out, I have to pinpoint the idea of what maybe talk about here. I think it's deeper. I think it talks about, like, overall black communities going through their fair shares of ups and downs, and how we progress from that to where we was then to where we are at now. We still go through our own, you know, just trials and tribulations. But I have a big feeling in my heart. We'll get through it. Like Bob Marley says, I'm going to keep smiling. I'm going to keep, you know, doing me. Keep being me. That's all you can do. And keep each other in prayers as well. So with that being said, you guys, if you enjoy this reaction, I hope I did a good enough reaction for you guys. If you enjoy this Concrete Jungle, you know, official audio reaction, keep requesting for more songs by Bob Marley or artists that are very similar. And yeah. Like, comment, subscribe, and views. Put your minds out there. The link of this song will be down in my description below. This was Bob Marley and the Wailers, Concrete Jungle, the official audio produced by Jack Newber, Chris Blackwell, and Bob Marley himself from the album Catch a Fire. King Life, we are out.